One of the things that I think has been interesting this morning is the way that this is not, particularly in this communication, is that in a terrifying way, one requires that there is getting everything to go. So we really need to think about what our learners need to learn, and why do they need to learn, and therefore what do they need to learn. So when we thought about learning teaching and assessment strategy, we really want to be close to a transformative education, to traffic and traffic system, or something. The fact that graduates are not in the was important. Taking time to get expertise in the world, that's why we they already started to train in knowledge, if you don't retain the professional socialization of students, of core values, you actually can know how to become whatever it is you want to become, which is formative learning, and find the same way that we're going to be able to successfully the was for the victim, so each of the customers was their regard to victims, but was seeking to enter their digest for one day. The reason for the event is that it was started by private education and is currently being led by the students in the program. I'm going to hand over to Anne, who will actually talk to you about what kind of education she has to offer. So in terms of operationalizing public education, it is really possible to state that it is not a concrete concept for the UK and the other countries to facilitate the UK. Instead, we focus on first the undergraduate curriculum, so we have a major project such as the but also looking at key elements to support students in the so what is personal structure identity and the reform of the system that I have this morning? So the three ways to the idea is that by the time the students graduate, they will be able to do the first year of 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 So I want to focus on the rules and the concrete elements of protecting special interests for the future, and securities against novel and defensible. So working with them as an interdisciplinary group works very which is the capacity to apply knowledge and skills to deal with diversity and the ability to learn and grow as a So these are the nine key stories that we teach students. They focus on mindset and thinking. The way to think differently about the barriers and the consequences that you end up with on the learning, I'll call the world's longest economies. Specific skills that can be used in a challenging situation, and then looking at mind and emotions and intelligent communication in different situations. So, thank you for the different kinds of social and different techniques. So we have embedded this then from the very beginning of the kitchen, So moving on from zero and science to lifestyle medicine, and lifestyle medicine is going to be a moment because we have embedded this again for the curriculum from the rural regions of the lifestyle medicine is a and as well as embedded in the curriculum, we also have an action certificate in lifestyle medicine that students can take. We introduced it in 2020 and we tapped them on for 250 and then it reached its goal over the years, so it seems to be a very popular option. It's a completely online certificate in about 50 to 60 hours of student effort. And it focuses on two core pillars of lifestyle medicine, which is physical activity, nutrition, sleep, self-management, smoking, and anti-aging disease. And so we offer a program we talked about in the form of this review for our students. We also get them to focus on themselves and the importance of their own lifestyle behaviors and how they might be able to change for their own success. So they're assessed through conclusive online content, through the criticism added to the content, they're reflecting that the process is finished, and then they're tasked with the assignment over the summer months. They focus on assessing behavior zones and do kind of detailed project in life. Growth mindset, then, is the philosophical backdrop to the curriculum. And it's really about enhancing the student's mindset in a way, and to encourage them to have a fixed mindset around the students that they have. And we're doing this, they're talking to students about their own strategy. The interactions with students, we focus very much on language relating to success and failure, language relating to mistakes and to learning. And we capture this in our personal student training, in personal student reasons, we do that with the students around this area. It's embedded in our assessment that students will come back to, in the national sector assignments and also in the way students receive feedback, and we just focus on feedback in the moment. So we know from research that contrary to the intention, feedback can also have a it's not really a good strategy, and it can have a damaging impact on students' confidence,
and belief and that people get this food that they want to do. So, in terms of setting up opportunities for our students and our students, rather than kind of fixed questions that students have to say, what do you do with this assessment? I'm afraid that you go wrong. We adopt a growth mindset approach to those questions that say, what is the progress that we've made so far? And what did you do next to improve? Which is a very different and then for students, we encourage students to ask themselves, what is the time to achieve? How much progress have you made so far? And what could you do next to improve? So again, it's about to find some different students to figure out themselves what they can improve. So again, we just briefly on this after the foundation, these are quite fundamental changes for our curriculum. It's important that we know that they're working. We start to publish but the key assessment principles themselves that we are working towards, which I have again said as part of that larger coaching project, the key factor. So, John Jenkins, which is our next year, is going to bring more to the client, really help us decide to move along the journey where we want to be engaged. We want to code it out into the assessment and then start to train learning activities that they work towards the beginning. And also, we're going to be using the assessment of integrating life cleanly. And fundamentally, I think it's going to be so much academic as feeling in the room that assessment is not a separate measure of achievement or a standard measure of achievement. And it can't be thought of as this for the students or the faculty. So for us, it's going to be a much smaller assessment for our relative to academic rule. Growing up, when I'm in medicine, taking love by the way, hold up your fire, because I'm not going to be much of a person for the Muslim scale, including to get most of them fast. But it seems focused on getting straight, and our assessment is focused on supporting the learning process rather than merely measuring the product. This approach does require students to take responsibility for the learning process and their engagement, and it does require additional focus. And that's really why all of the work and the research that Anne has spoken to is an absolutely integral part of what we do. We don't think it's a good one at home. So we have program level learning outcomes that are linked to a very actively curriculum data space, but into module level learning outcomes. And the module level learning outcomes in the credits can then map across to the pillars. So it's really explicit to students that this module might have more knowledge, but this one might have more in curriculum. And then for learners, we hope that to make the sort of evaluative judgment that the Duke University was talking to this morning, that they are they building their knowledge by learning what they need to at the stage of their training? Are they building skills that they need to develop and developing the professional attributes and qualities that will help them perform in practice and practitioners? And we think about the things that we want to come from our individual learning platform and really move away from this world learning and attracting people. So the key ways we're doing this is to put it out of the system so programmatic model assessments ensure that the degree means is where learners are included but progressively assessed as they move forward. And the progress platform that we're implementing around Severn and the sequestered master of year one of the program, but it will be rolled out throughout all years of the program. So students from every year will be doing the same progress test ultimately at pretty much the same time in years to come. So progress has been using assessment format. Versions of the final year, four knowledge of assessments will be presented to the students just for time training. And this encourages them to do an extension of those important areas throughout their program, and it gives them a sense of depth of question, and it's like long time for the questions that they pose in that previous slide. How the first thing that I can think in SSI is based on SBAs with four options. So we want learners to figure out what their knowledge gaps are. We don't want them to take wrong guesses, so they're either negative action or negative marking for the wrong answer. But we do want them to start making a value decision. So I think I've covered that. I think I'm pretty sure if these two of those answers, I'm going to do it again. But we don't want them to make wrong guesses because nobody in the room wants to go from that to the middle of the so knowing what you really don't know is important. But in this low stakes scenario, it's going to be wrong. We do want them to start to make them wrong guesses. We have managed to ask the question in the first year test, we only want them to get the best one in the 160 questions right. So a lot of this is about communicating and working with students. It requires them to unlearn some of the things that got them to university, you know, and don't leave any blanks in any of those papers, always have something done. Don't leave the assessment before you find out that something might take them the best. And actually this model used for the first year is something quite different. So we have a responsibility to progress testing is not new. When it comes to the disease phase, it's a common work that into the present is fairly widespread in medical education. So that's the concept and concept that's taken us about 4 or 5 years to get ahead of it and to get all of the same work that all of the methods of testing is to come to. So, is it working in physical testing? So, very much in our agency for this, but we have denied the best of surveys from the Quality Office and the Council of Studies that we pulled out from the students. Actually, it's not completely what our students are happy with it. They get the sense of the programmatic assessment, what they should have assessment, and the way that they have to be. But I think the one in the red, that's the one that made me happiest when I saw it. So, the student has said, I've had an knowledge check in the middle of the week or so, make me organize my time, but I've got to keep in touch with my learning. I want to spend my learning and help me run contests rather than just random tests. And just recently, I'm going to get jobs with people. I'm sure there'll be other parts of the feedback that we need to adjust. And so my thing is, my last slide is next steps. We have a lot to learn. We are growing this out, but we have a commitment really to keep growing. And as we work with the government and the government, we're going to publicize what we find and then to help with this collection of dialogue. So, just on behalf of Anne and I, thank you very much for the chance to talk to you.